Chapter 3 Decimals. Hello children. In our day-to-day life, we see the use of decimals everywhere, like money, weight, length, etc. In previous classes, we have studied and learned about the basics of decimals and its operation. Like, decimal number consists of two parts, a whole number part and decimal part. We have also studied about place value of decimals. Now, we will learn and study some more about decimal. Like, multiplication of a decimal number with 10, 100 and 1000. On multiplying a decimal number by 10, the decimal point shifts one place to the right. On multiplying a decimal number by 100, the decimal point shifts two places to the right. And in case of 1000, the decimal point shifts three places to the right. For example, 5.436 multiplied by 10 is equal to 54.36. 5.436 multiplied by 100 is equal to 543.6. And 5.436 multiplied by 1000 is equal to 5436. Multiplication of a decimal number with a whole number. Suppose the cost of one chocolate is 3.5 and you have to purchase 7 chocolates. Can you find the total cost? To multiply a decimal number with a whole number, find the product of numbers ignoring the decimal point. Then, put the decimal point in the product, starting from the right as many places as given in the decimal number. Thus, cost of 7 chocolates is 24.5. Multiplication of a decimal number with a decimal number. To find the product of two decimal numbers, we simply multiply the whole numbers ignoring the decimal point. Then, put the decimal point in the product from the right. The number of decimal places in the product is equal to the sum of the number of decimal places in the given decimal numbers. For example, Rashi's mother purchase 2.5 kg of tomatoes. The cost of 1 kg of tomatoes is 30.50. How much money did Rashi's mother pay to Green Grocer? For this, we will simply multiply the cost of 1 kg of tomatoes with total number of quantity she took, that is 30.50 into 2.5. We will first multiply ignoring the decimal, and it will be 7625. Then, we will put the decimal point in the product from the right number of decimal places in the product is equal to the sum of the number of decimal places in the given decimal numbers. Thus, she will have to give 76.25 to the shopkeeper. In this way, we can multiply the decimal numbers together. Now, we will learn and study about division of a decimal number by 10, 100 and 1000. On dividing the decimal number by 10, 100 or 1000, the decimal point shifts to the left by same number of places as there are zeros in the divisor. For example, if we divide 3646 by 10, we will shift decimal place to the left by one place and it will be 3.646. If we divide 3646 by 100, we will shift decimal place to the left by 2 place and it will be 36.46. And if we divide 3646 by 1000, we will shift decimal place to the left by 3 place and it will be 364.6. On dividing a decimal number by a non-zero whole number, we divide the decimal number by the whole number by ignoring the decimal point. Then, we put the decimal point in the quotient counting from right after as many digits as there are decimal places in the dividend. In this way, we can divide the decimals together. In previous classes, we have already learned about metric system, measurement of length, mass and volume. Now, we will study the same concept in decimal system. The given table shows the different prefixes used in metric system, their values in decimal system, and fractions of their standard units. We will learn how to convert one unit into the other. To convert a greater unit into a smaller unit, we multiply the unit by the required multiplying factor. To change the larger units into smaller unit, we multiply by 10 and its multiple as the units increases, like to convert 1 kilo into hecto, we will multiply the given kilo quantity by 10. To convert 1 kilo into deca, we will multiply it by 100 and so on. Similarly, to change the smaller units into larger unit, we divide by 10 and its multiple as the units decreases. Like, to convert 1 hecto into kilo, we will divide the given hecto quantity by 10. To convert 1 deca into kilo, we will divide it by 100 and so on. Thus, the given table of conversion will help you to understand it more clearly. So, children, that's all in this chapter. Hope you have understood the chapter very well.